QSFP and QSFP-DD are commonly used transceivers these days. But did you know that they are backward compatible to each other? If you want to find out how, stick around. Now, in order to see how that compatibility actually works, we need to look at the electrical end of the pluggable module. Where the QSFP has four electrical lanes on this connector, and that's how they are connected, a block of four such electrical lanes. Whereas the QSFP-DD, which has eight electrical lanes, has a longer connector. So the module is larger, it sticks out more in the front, but it's also longer in this end here. The connector is longer, and the first set of electrical lanes is connected at the exact same physical position, whereas another set of another four electrical lanes is positioned behind it. That's why this connector is longer. You can also see that clearly on these pictures. QSFP and QSFP-DD, which are with a longer electrical connection here. And how does this lead to that compatibility? Let's start with QSFP again. If a QSFP module is plugged into a QSFP host, it connects those four lanes inside the connector. Whereas when I try to connect a QSFP-DD module with that longer connection into that same connection here, that does not fit. It does not fit in here, so a QSFP-DD module cannot be used in a regular QSFP host. Whereas when I have a QSFP-DD host with an appropriate connection, that will obviously connect the DD module on four and four electrical lanes. And this is where that clever trick leads to a QSFP module using only the first set of electrical lanes, and the second set of such lanes will simply remain unused. So if this host actually supports that QSFP module, it will bring this to work as well. So I hope this makes sense to you. If you learned something today, please leave a comment. See you next time.